Hello, I'm Sean, a junior retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And here I'm rendering exposition of St. Matthew 23, verse 1 to 12. And Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. We have natural Father of this one. Our soul is supernatural. So He came from our supernatural Father. This natural Father, you have sex and you produce children. Our supernatural Father has no physical self. So His light is His children. So Christ is the light, so Christ was the Son of the Most High. He represented Him in light. So we call Christ in Punjabi Satguru. So Jesus was the first Satguru. Sat means gospel truth, and Guru means who preaches gospel. Gospel is preached, it's not taught, it's not letters that can be written down in book and you can vomit them out. It is something you have to get it, acquire it yourself through logical reasoning. And the end product is logo, and logo is His word. So here I'm doing St. Matthew 23, verse 1 to 12. Jesus spoke to the crowds and to the twice born laborers. Now Jesus had no disciples. The root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline natural boys of 12 to 16 years old through the moral law of Moses. So Rabbi, Pharisee, Sadducee, John the Baptist, they had disciples, but not Jesus. In Jesus, we are twice born laborers, which he picked up because He knew the quality of our heart. So He picked up those who are longing for gospel and who were prepared to work in the royal vineyard of our Father, where the true wine, Christ Jesus, has been planted by our Father. Just a minute. I show you the royal vineyard. Then you will appreciate. Yeah, this is the royal vineyard. John the Baptist prepared the sons of man, water, baptism of water. And then they were sensible enough to look for the narrow gate. This is the narrow gate where the killing of His word is there to enter the royal kingdom of God. With the true vine, Christ Jesus is planted. And we graft ourselves to this true vine to become like Christ Jesus. And at the Last Supper they were, that they have to hire an insider, Iscariot, to pinpoint who is the real Christ. Now this design, I made it on a t-shirt. And it is all the Christianity in a nutshell. But people laugh, you know, because they had no interest in these things. So gospel is by grace, and if somebody wants this design, I can send it over if he send me email. So Jesus had laborers employed in the vineyard of our Father, not the once-born natural disciples, as of the rabbis, saying, the scribes and the Pharisees have taken their seat on the chair of Moses. Moses gave them the letters, law. Letters of the law are the written Torah. Transgression against the moral law is sin in ignorance. So children, you know, they were their intake 12 to 16 years old, and if they made a mistake, then the rabbi will tell them, hey, you have committed a sin, go home and bring this thing for me. He will fine him in material things. But in Jesus, we are not under rabbis anymore, but under our own Father, one Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. So if you make mistake in His name, He punishes you. He won't let you go free. Therefore, do and observe all things they tell you. That means do what the rabbis tell you to do, because they are telling you the law, but do not follow their example, in which they knew the law, that means they knew the law perfectly because they were the law masters. But they did wrong things knowingly against the Holy Spirit inside you, or the oral Torah, which is blasphemy or hypocrisy. So it's no more sin, you know, when you tell lies from your own heart. As Ananias and Sapphira, remember, they sold their properties and they colluded with each other that we keep back money and we only give small amount to the present to the Peter. When they came to Peter and told him this is all they got of this out of the sale of their property, then he rebuked them, you know, that we did not force you to join. You are coming to this fold of Church of God headed by Christ Jesus of your own free will. So why keep back money and tell me lies? That was not lie, because it was a blasphemy against Holy Spirit. They were both hypocrites, and hypocrites, he killed them. And because hypocrites are rotten egg in a church, and this priest, dog-colored priest in the church, he is the greatest hypocrite. He tells other people that he is working for God, but he is not working for God, he is working for money. He retires at 65 and then he enjoys his life. And there was a survey in the newspaper, you know, which is the best profession. And it turned out to be that of a priest, more caring free and more comfortable. You can see what type of these people are. For they teach the scripture and not preach gospel. In the Bible is written preach, you know, it is wrong. The scriptures are taught and not preach. Gospel is preached like a sower. So they teach the scripture and not preach gospel that comes from your own heart, but they do not practice. That is, they are sitting in the manger like the barking dogs. They themselves not enter into the kingdom of heaven, not royal kingdom of God. In the kingdom of heaven, which is seen in law and order. Because when they are themselves are hypocrite, what type of students they will create then? More hypocrite than themselves. So that creates mess in the world. So that is kingdom of heaven is seen with these two eyes in law and order. Whereas the royal kingdom of God is of our heart, which is inside us, which you can't see, but you have to perceive through the deeds of the person, what type of person you are dealing with. Then you will know that this is a man of God or not. So royal kingdom of God is within your heart, while the kingdom of heaven is outside in law and order. Here is the book, you know, which I have written and is described here. And here is the name of the book, which is available on the internet. You can download it. A revision has been made of this one, but I need help, technical help, to put up the tables and make a print edition. So, dog-collared priests, they themselves not enter the kingdom of heaven in speaking truth, and they won't let the people speak the truth, as Pope did by killing people. You know, anybody who was speaking the truth or anything against Pope or expressed his own opinion, and they were killed by the Pope. In Oxford, I think it's 1500 something, two people were burnt at stake, Latimer and somebody else. They tie up heavy burdens of rituals, hard to carry. Ritual, you know, in the morning you should do this thing, kosher and all that thing, you know, pray, fast and everything, and lay them on people's shoulder, but they will not lift a finger or forgive their sins as warning to move them. You know, they will tell you, you know, if you are sick or even say you are not well, you must come to the synagogue. And then he will tell you, oh, okay, you can stay at home, but you must come. Whereas these tax collectors, they were not stupid people. Otherwise, they won't be a tax collector if they are stupid, you know. So they, seeing the hypocrisy of these rabbis, they won't attend their synagogue. They were atheists, and they proclaim them sinners because it is the one of the moral laws that on Sabbath you should attend the synagogue. But they were not. So they were proclaimed sinners, and those were the ones who were seeking Christ Jesus the most at Passover. They were looking forward to speak to him, to listen to him. So all their works are performed to be seen, as today you have hireling dog-collared priests in the churches. They are whitewashed up from outside, full of filth inside. Hypocrites. Like Billy Graham, buried in useless prayers and fasting. When our Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, this is the temple of God. Where does the God live? In his temple or outside? In his temple, if the temple is clean, no blood money in it, no cheating. If you are cheat, then Satan is inside, God is out. In useless prayers, when our Father is within us, called Emmanuel, that is why it is called Emmanuel. Not that Jesus, they call Jesus Emmanuel. They don't know that God is inside you. You need to be priest of God. It's called royal priest and it's called Christ. So Christ is known to the Christ, Jesus. Our Christ within you will perceive the value of Christ Jesus. They widen their phylacteries and lengthen their tassels. As you see today, the Russian bishops, Russian Orthodox bishops, you know, their hat, big hat, and all that is worth seeing. And all that, you know, robes and with all this marking and all that, you know, dressed to frighten the ordinary simpletons. Then when you see such a dressed person, you know, hey, ordinary man is frightened of him. It's only people like me who can challenge them, and we call them Antichrist at their face value. I went to Germany to attend Kirchentag, which was Catholic, I attended to three or four Christian Catholic, and I have been attending the Protestant Kirchentag. This year also I attended, but I'm not going anymore because they don't wish, they don't honor you, because when you speak the gospel truth, they don't like it. So over there I went there, and some Swiss pastor was there. And I told him, you know, Judas Iscariot used to hold the purse, and whenever he wanted money, he will dip his hand into the purse and steal money for his personal use. For being a thief, he was thrown out at the Last Supper. And same, you know, you people in the churches, people donate money to the church purse. At the end of the month, you dip your hand into the purse to steal money as your salary, and you are a thief like Judas Iscariot. You yourself can't enter into the royal kingdom of God. How can your congregation members can enter? Oh, they were furious. So, however, in one of these Catholic Kirchentag I went, there was a priest, a Catholic priest, with nice black robe, well-dressed cup, out clean outside and full of filth inside. So I asked him, you know, when Jesus died on the cross, the curtain of the holiest of holy was torn from top to bottom. Top mean the temple high priest, bottom mean the village rabbi. Out you go. Then the you have a direct approach to God. Nobody can stand between man and God. If anybody stand, he is Antichrist. So when I told him nobody can stand, then he said, oh, I'm just a guide. I said, what about if you are a blind guide? So I told him, anybody who stand between man and God, he's Antichrist, and you are one of them. When I pointed finger at him, you know, he pointed, ah, you called me Antichrist. Then I asked him, then where you stand? Or you justify? He could not. Then we laughed and shook hands, you know. So this is the situation, you know, you have now in the these Orthodox people and bishops and these priests and churches, they are all Antichrist who stand between man and God. We have in Jesus onefold Church of God, headed by one shepherd, Christ Jesus, and we are royal priest. Royal priests are greater than priest. Royal priests give to the church. They don't steal money from the church, as Christ or St. Paul has stressed. Just the opposite. You know what applied to flesh, the opposite to spirit. So royal priests give the church. If we are royal priests, we don't need any. So we have a fellowship of royal priests. When you go to a church, then you should enjoy the fellowship, not this dog collar priest coming in and telling you what to do. So this is all cheat, you know, going on in this world. Bishop dressed to frighten their ordinary simpletons. They love places of honor at banquets, seats of honor in synagogues to represent Moses. Greetings in marketplaces, such as Father, they will tell him, and the salutation, Rabbi, the moral teacher. As for you, do not be called Rabbi, because we are not moral teacher. We don't deal with, we preach gospel. Gospel is preached by a Christ, like a sower. Some seed fell on the flat ground and so, whereas the letters, you can go to university and they will teach you the letters and you reproduce them at the examination and you get a degree. That's how you got the dog collar license. You can put, I asked them, can I get one? No, you have to go to get a degree or something, and then your church must support it. And so then they give you a letter, you know, binding you. Jesus set us free, not bound us. So these priests in the churches, they are antichrist. In Jesus, we are royal priest. As for you, do not be called rabbi, the teacher of written Torah, the scriptures. You have but one teacher, the Christ within your own heart. Christ is sitting in the temple of God in your own heart. And if you let the bridegroom come inside Christ Jesus, then you, in his honor, then you preach gospel. Remember this one? This is the bridegroom, and he knocks at your heart. And if you let him in, then Christ within us can talk to our anointed elder brother, Christ Jesus. You have but one teacher, the Christ within your own heart, and you are all divine brethren, extending agape love, which is greater than the arrow's love that Moses created among the chosen people in the wilderness to stop infighting for unity. Remember that Moses was in Egypt, where some Egyptian soldiers killed a chosen person who was a slave. And next day, you know, Moses killed that soldier. And sometime later, two chosen people were fighting with each other. He told them, "Hey, you are brethren. We have one father, Abraham. Why you fight with each other?" But they were still carrying on. They told him, "Who made you a judge? Get lost." So he did not interfere. He was disappointed. And that's why he left the Egypt and went to the other place where he had the burning bush, which is Christ. Christ has brought fire. And that was the example of that fire. And Moses then entered that sanctuary, or he put on Christ, and then he wrote Torah. So this fighting between, as you remember, Adam and Eve, it was the snake, serpent, who caused rift among them and made them to sin. Same way that rift, when the two brothers were fighting, that was a snake causing it between them. In the wilderness, Moses lifted up that rift, made them the sons of the one father, Abraham. And that snake was lifted and they were brethren, no more infighting. So this is the type of snake which Moses lifted. And Jesus, being greater than Moses, he lifted snake among the countries, not to fight with each other, but to exercise divine love called agape. So here's what I have written. So love Christ within your own heart, and you are all divine brothers, extending agape love, which is greater than the arrows, love that Moses created among the chosen people in the wilderness, to stop infighting for unity. Call no one on earth your father, such as these robed Orthodox fake fathers are. They, you know, if you don't call them father, they are angry. I call them brother, or no, then some of these fathers will tell me, "Now, we are not brother, we are fathers." And they are so, you know, brainwashed. You have but one Father, God, called Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., in heaven. Do not be called Master. When you are Master, you know, you become Lord or the Lord that have slaves. Because you can't give their account to people. If you become a Lord, then the people who are slave to you, you can't give their account to God. That is, Rabbi used to give the account of the people to God at Passover. So you are worse than those rabbis from the yoke of which Jesus set us free. So the lords that have slaves, you have but one anointed elder brother, Christ Jesus, our bridegroom, the Messiah. The greatest among you must be your slave, must be your servant. Which is just the opposite of rabbinic system of temple, of the temple high priest and his students. Remember that Messianic Jews on occupying the Church of God, headed by Christ Jesus, they established a similar administrative system as was of the temple priest, or as it was in the temple, from the yoke of which Jesus set us free. And they fulfilled Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. So it's a very simple gospel. However, exalts himself. However, who exalts himself will be humbled, and whoever humbles himself will be exalted in the sainthood by God, and not by the Antichrist Pope. Pope, you know, said making people saint and this thing. He himself is Antichrist. How can he make people saint? So that means they are befooling people. So I've put a lot of videos on YouTube. And if you are interested, have a look and send me your feedback. Our Father God bless you. And the end of the world is coming, not far away. It will be in 2023, when Israel is 75 years old. For 70 years, nobody can touch Israel. That means up to May 2018, Israel is safe. But after that, it won't be safe. You will see how people will attack Israel, left and right. And the Jews will be running to Israel for final burning. You are Jews outwardly, of appearance, and not of the heart. They are super bastard fanatic devils. John 8, verse 44. Jesus told them in the temple that your forefathers were liars, and they were super bastard fanatic devils. And in reply, they retorted, "We are born of legitimate parents. We are not bastards." But they are super, because Jesus dealt with supernatural. A Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. Outwardly they are of Levi tribe, Benjamin tribe, Judah tribe. All these tribals are here. But when they become Jew outwardly, they have replaced their tribal self. Tribals have thrown out, replaced by Jew. And when they replace it with Jew, they become super bastard fanatic devils. And that's what they are causing in the Middle East now. All the trouble, because you have two things. God, which is mammon free, and you have mammon and media sitting on the heap of mammon. It is the power of the mammon in USA which is causing all that trouble in the Middle East. But the time is coming next year, you will see. People are not spiritually blind. people have conscience, and that conscience is going to speak up soon, making the Jew to run for Israel for protection. And when they are nicely bundled up, as they were in 70 AD, then atomic war will happen in 2023. Our Father knows better, and our Father blesses you.